Guys, welcome back to our repair, guys. In today's video we'll be working here on the Fiesta and we'll show you how to remove an instrument cluster on generation 2008 to 2017. We have more than 200 videos on this car. We'll be taking the whole car apart, so if you need anything, subscribe, let us know, we'll try to make a video, and let's start on it now. So the first step will be to disconnect your battery, and it's important how you do that. When you disconnect the battery, you need to disconnect the negative cable first. Okay, this is the negative minus cable, and positive second. And why you do that? It's because if you don't disconnect the negative and you disconnect the positive and accidentally touch it to the body of the car, you still have connection and you can burn the computer or at least the fuse. So we're going to disconnect the negative and the positive after that as well. Make sure that they're not going to touch. If you think they do, make sure you put a glove or something underneath them. Okay, and let's proceed with the next step. So we'll need to, for the cluster now, we'll need to wait at least 30 minutes to an hour after you disconnect the battery to make sure that you don't have any electrical problems, and then we'll bring the steering wheel all the way towards me. Okay, you can see. Okay, and you need to bring it all the way towards you and down. You can lock it in place after that. Okay, next. Okay, this trim right here, this is removable. You just push it out of the way. Okay, like that. And now, what you can do, you can actually remove the whole trim if you want to. And let me get a trim removal tool. Okay, like this one here. And you can pop those things open. Okay, and you can pull that thing out of there. So now for the cluster, okay, we have, okay, let me check what this one is. This is actually with the Torx. We have two screws, one here and one over there. So it's actually with a Torx 20. Okay, all the tools that we use will be in the description of the video. It's very important not to drop the screw in the steering column there. You can still find it. I dropped the tool before, but it took quite a bit of time. Okay, this one is almost out. Okay, this is the screw. Okay, that's what it looks like. And that's how long it is. Same thing on this side over here. Okay, this one is out as well. So now with a small flathead screwdriver, there is one cap that we need to remove. Be gentle not to break it, okay, or anything like that. And when you install it, it goes only one certain way, okay, because there is one thing that sticks out. And once you remove this one, guys, you have one more screw, okay, right here, hidden. So we'll need to remove this one too. Again, it's a Torx screw. And I believe that this one will not fit in there, so what we will need to do, most likely, we need to get a small ratchet to get in there. So we got a shorter screwdriver now, and we should be able to get it. It's actually a power screwdriver. Okay, and you have the same screw as what you had before. Okay, now let's see if it's going to come out or we need to do anything else. Okay, we stopped here somewhere. So you need to lift it up here a little bit. No, it's a tight fit. Okay. It came out. Next, we will have to disconnect the cables, and this one, you have one tooth on here that you need to press down. Okay, and after that, you slide this thing out. Okay, and it comes like that. Next, you have the same thing on this side. Okay, let me show you. This tooth needs to go down in the middle. Okay, and once you press it down, you slide, okay, that glide towards the front. Okay, and next we need to get a clip remover too. Okay, right here we have one clip that holds the wires, okay, in place, and this one is really, really tight. Okay, one more over here, the same thing. Okay, so let's see if this one is going to come out as well. It's easier with the clip remover too, but okay, almost out. Sometimes if they never ever been removed, it will not be easy, I guarantee you that. Okay, this one is out, and you can see, guys, this is the instrument cluster. That's how you guys remove it. So when you're ready to install it, all you have to do is just put it back together in reverse order that you took it apart. Thank you for watching, don't forget to subscribe, and see you next time.